All right, welcome back to the shop, you guys. Today, I want to talk to you about what I have in this box. It's going to be really cool. Well, yes, I still have this mess going on here in the shop, and it's okay. I know I'll catch up with everything. Right now, this is the current state of what I'm working on, is this tank for my Coleman stove, the 413F. No, this is the, let me see. Yeah, this is the 413F. I have a 413E over there, but on this F model, the tank was very dirty. I had to clean it and empty it all out, did all that. Then I had to take out the valve and the generator and everything, and I cleaned all that stuff up, so all the parts are here. And before I go on with that, I need these tools, so I'm going to put these on the side. We'll pause that and talk about this. All right. Now, my local shop, auto body shop, or auto supply store, right? Okay. It's a local chain around here, family owned, family run. Great place. They had these on sale Christmas time. And they still have, I don't know, a handful of them hanging there. And they're only $105 for you guys. Okay, for us. $105. Now, I thought it was expensive at first until I started looking at all the individual pieces that are there that they sell separately. When you put it all together, I mean, it's basically you're getting almost like a $60 value if you go this way versus if you try to buy all four in separately. So the pack is the way to go. Anyway, I've seen people call these before Knipex, Knipex, Knipex. I don't know. It's a German brand. And I have some of their older stuff, but I don't have any of this newer stuff. What are we going to call it? Knipex, Knipex, whatever it is. But anyway, it comes in this cool, holiday Christmas package. So let's take it apart. And the unit here is, it says Knipex, 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 holiday gift set. Hang on. Oh, so here's the nut. So we got the 8-inch. Man, it's all these different. Look at that. There's Spanish. Here's English. And here's French. Okay, I guess. So it comes with the 8-inch long pliers with the cutter, a 10-inch high leverage diagonal cut cutter, and an 8-inch twin grip pliers, 10-inch alligator water pump pliers. What I like about these is they get such a nice grip. Now my old pair of these are totally different application. But okay, here we go. What I really like about this, how it's packaged real nice. See that? It's got the good, it was all rolled up in there. Now I'll slowly bring out this whole box that it's in. Put that over here to the side. Come on now. There we go. Oh yeah, look at that. So, you know what? Let me bring you in a little bit closer. All right, so these first ones up, we have the Knipex. I'm just gonna call them Knipex, you guys. These are the 8-inch long nose pliers with the cutter. Okay, it's got that cutter. And what I like about these things, and they're coated. They have a nice oil on there. These are, very close to precision. Okay, they're real smooth, very tight tolerances in there. Very tight tolerances. So this is the Knipex 26200. Again, made in Germany, I guess. Yep, made in Germany. Very nicely machined. Now, these are a little different than our standard. You know, these are the ones I've been using forever. I've got a few different pair of these. These are some older American-made ones. You can see the difference. It's a little bit longer. This, the new Knipex, Knipex. A lot longer nose. Okay, a lot longer nose. It's gonna help. And that cutter, I want to make sure I keep that cutter clean and not put any nicks in it, because I don't want to mess things up like that. So these original pair that I have, that I won't throw away, they don't really have a cutter per se. They have this little slot here where you can, you know, you can put a wire, but these have been blown out once before. You can see it's been, it must have been a hot wire somebody grabbed on and kind of blew them out. This one is nice and flat. No blowouts yet. Hopefully it stays that way. So these are the 8-inch pliers, needle nose. Now these next ones are the 8-inch twin grip pliers, which, you guys, these are so cool. If you can see how that is angled in there, you see, whoops, so much better it's gonna be at gripping. Hang on, the chickens are over here. Get out! Go on! Get out of here! Go! You too! Go! Get! Go! Stay out! Ugh! Alright, sorry. But anyway, you see how they're offset. And the teeth in here, man, really nice teeth. If you can tell what there is, there's all these teeth like we normally have in, you know, needle nose, or channel lock or standard pliers, right? These ones have that, but they're also curved like a radius. And then down here at the fine edge, they still have all these nice teeth. And then if you turn and look, you see that little round, hole, divot type of thing? Well, look, if you have to get in on top of something, for example, you know, if you have to reach in there and get on top of something, you can do that because it's going to fit right there. And it has opposite striations or cuts in the teeth. Look at that. So there's another set of teeth in there. That is really cool. So these are like more of precision style. See how nice that's going to be? And they're adjustable. You just push this and it slides over to fit those bigger nuts and bolts. And, you know, it's got the adjustment in there so you can do different adjustments. Just push this around and slide it around wherever you want it. So that's going to, and the grip, it's not a smooth grip like these ones are smooth grip. This one has a grip on there that is, it's coarse. It kind of feels like my, kind of like a pistol grip. Okay, it's got what do you guys call it? It is the, I guess stippling? It's not stippling though, it's something else. It's nice though. Okay, so let's go on to these next ones. These are the 10-inch high leverage diagonal cutter. So look at that. That's way, I'll be able to reach into stuff way in there and cut. And look, that is, again, this machining is so cool. So nice and tight. I have to clean some of this up. Oh, there's a chicken right there. What are you doing? So that cut, it's a nice flat cut and it's tapered. You see it's got an angle to it. It's got that angle. So you can actually reach in there to get things. You don't have to be flat and smooth. You can, you know, you'll be up a little bit so you don't have to, you know, you have space for your fingers is what I'm saying. Again, I don't want to cut live wire with these because you'll blow out the back side and that's not good. You want to keep these nice and flat, straight, in one piece without tearing stuff up. So yeah, excited to clean this or to use these pliers. Now the last set here are these 10-inch, they call them alligator water pump pliers. To me, they're very similar to our channel locks, except better. Okay, that doesn't mean I'm gonna throw my channel locks away. I'm keeping these, you know, I've got a ton of these. I'm not getting rid of those, but these are more special. You guys see again these offset teeth and everything. See how they're shaped? So when you open, it's gonna bite down. And, oh yeah, and look at, I can adjust anything. I can adjust all these little spots. See that? And then, look at that. These are so cool. So for example, if I, in a tight spot or whatever it is, if I don't have the proper wrench around, I can get in there. You see how it's gonna fit? Let me make it a little bit smaller. right here. For example, I'll use this, the nut on this thing for the, wow. You guys, it's gonna hold on. I mean, look at that. It will hold on and not slip. It's got that, I like that angle too. It's a little bit better than this angle. Something about it, it just makes me, it's just a little bit different angle. You see that? These ones are just for flat, okay? See how they're just straight, just flat. But these new Knipex have that, I don't know, they're just that precision end up in there and all that, you guys. I'm excited to use these. As I said, they're brand new. They still have the coating on it. I have to wipe it down a bit, but look, it's going to go from little things all the way up to some big, big nuts or bolts that you can't reach. It's going to go to all that stuff, so. Huh. Oh, look at that. So you're not going to smash your fingers. It's got the stopper. See that stopper right there? Well, as you can see, I'm very excited about these new pliers, this new plier set. Again, I'll show you, it's the Knipex, 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 however you want to say it. I don't know the right way yet, but this kit, you know, a four-piece set for $105. They still have a few up there on the wall hanging. So finally, I get these things out of the box. I can use them. I just wanted to make this little video for you guys to see. I know a ton of you guys out there already use this stuff. But as I'm going through my tools, I've got everything narrowed down, whittled down to American-made stuff. Snap-on. What else do I have? Matco. I have Williams. Craftsman. A lot of Craftsman. But I'm purging all my tools. Now, you got to keep in mind, I have tools that were mine when I was a kid, including some of these boxes right here. Back in the 80s. 70s, 80s, into the 90s. My grandpa's the old stuff, which I love all that old stuff. A friend of mine's stuff after he died. So a lot of quality tools. So I'm purging if there's any, you know, China-made stuff, Taiwan-made stuff, you know, things like that that are cheaper. I have a box already over there. I'll show you guys in another video. I'm trying to put together and narrow down, whittle down my tool set that I use every day into quality tools, clean tools, new tools. I'm not going to get rid of some of the things that I use. I mean, everything that you see here, these are all American-made things that I already had. You know, I'm talking about even these old things like this, these old wooden cutter handles. I've got a bunch of these tools that are wooden, they're American made, and they're still great tools, you guys. I just keep them sharp. And but now with this Knipex, Knipex German set, and I'll have to dig out the other pair that I have from them. It's I don't know, it's just a good feeling to have, okay, in my shop. So what I'm doing with all the tools that I'm purging out, all those China made stuff, and I got a ton of it sitting over there, I'm looking for younger dudes that are just starting out that want to build, you know, on their own, you know, that are into this stuff too, okay? Let's face it. We need more males in this world to be skilled guys with their hands, be able to fix things, right? Well, if I can find a couple dudes to give my stuff to, I have an old set back there, toolbox. I would even give them those things. Remember those old toolboxes, old Craftsmen's with the, you know, you lift the door and you lift up the lid, you know, the walk-around tote that goes with it and all that stuff. All these kind of things. I would like to find some local kids that somebody that knows, you know, a young buck coming up that I can help build his stuff. You know, and those tools over there that I have are perfect for that. But I'm just excited to get these new tools up and into my box and get them in rotation, get them working. So look, I'm almost over this cold. I still have a little bit of a sinus. Man, this thing's been like 10 days, you guys, now with this. It's crazy. But the only thing left now is my sinuses. So they're draining a little bit. I'll be good soon. I want to finish this this Coleman stove, this two burner stove. All I have to do now is just put it all back together. So I'll get that film for you. Put it all back together, fire it up, wipe it all down, clean it, and this was good to go. And then I want to do the same thing too. I have two more over there, and then a lantern, and some other things that, you know, I love combing stuff. You know why? Because it's all that old American made stuff. Look at this old snap-on. This is an old snap-on half inch when they were making them all black. This one's called the GOEX 16-0B. I mean, I've got quite a bit of these little old snap-on things too, which I like that stuff, you guys. I want to show you what I've been updating my Craftsman stuff with too, but I've been going through a lot of my drawers. You know, Craftsman has their lifetime warranty, so I've been taking some ratchets, some broken ratchets, some broken sockets, and some broken screwdrivers and, you know, hand tools. And I've been getting those all updated and replaced too. Still working out a plan on all the stuff, but I want to narrow everything down so I don't have... I've got so much redundancy in these tools that it's driving me crazy because it's taking up my space, you know, and space is valuable. Clutter and all this, I'm trying to be more efficient and more, what's the right word? Unencumbered with all the stuff. Because remember, the stuff you own will eventually own you. You know, and I'm a believer of that. So clutter, I need to declutter. Declutter because it's going to make it easier for my everyday to go back and forth. And another thing I wanted to show you guys, oh yeah, I'm into knives too, okay, knife collection. I've got a decent knife collection started, and I've had it for years. And this is one of my knives that I dug out, and I think it was probably my grandpa's when he was little. And I never really paid attention to these things. But this knife, what I want to do, see, it's got a decent edge. It looks like the edge has been, I don't know, broken off at some point. But I sharpened it the other day, and boy, that thing gets sharp. Okay, but it's been used, it's been around. Okay, it's been around a lot. Look here. That's what I'm saying. This knife has been around. Okay, it might have even been one of my uncle's. But what I do like about this thing, it's American made. Look at it, it's got that cartridge shell. See that cartridge shell in the middle? Some detail right there. So it's got this little blade. I like that. But I haven't seen knives lately, modern, that also come with a bottle opener. A bottle opener with a flat screwdriver. So I want to get this all cleaned up, which I'll get it all shined up. And, you know, I might have to recreate this front tip. I don't know the name of this. I've been looking, I'm going to keep looking. It looks like it says USA, so I have to clean all these off. See if I can find some markings. But if you guys know what this is, man, I really love this. So this has been in my pocket now, I don't know, for the last week and a half. I want to clean it all out. And I like to rotate what's in my pocket, you know. Sometimes sometimes it's a new Gerber. Sometimes it's an old Buck. Sometimes it's something like this, or maybe it's one of my... just a razor knife, you know, to take out the razor. That Milwaukee Fastback, I've been carrying that around for a long time too, because there's a lot of cool stuff in it. But this is just about some tools and what I have in mind for my tool set. So if you guys have any suggestions on anything you've seen here or what I'm trying to get accomplished here with cleanup of my shop, because that's where it's at, is I'm sick of the clutter. I mean, if you go back a long time ago, one of my old videos, I have... my workshop nightmare or whatever, I can't remember what I call it, something like that. It's been a long time since I made that video, and the garage, the shop here, is in a lot better shape since then. This back wall right here, I had to redo that 2 times because raccoons got in there, took down all the insulation and all that, so I had to open it back up and redo it. So, you know, it's, you guys know what I'm going through. So anyway, that is it, you guys. I want to say thanks for stopping by again here in the workshop, looking at these tools. Am I saying it right? Knipex? 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 I don't know. But whatever it is, I have a pair, and they're right here. Free twin grip pliers. Huh. Excellent. So, leave me some comments. If you guys have any, you know, any ideas, suggestions, comments, questions, whatever it is, just send them down there. It can be about any of this stuff, the Coleman stuff, the tools, the, you know, the thing I'm trying to build for the young kids with the tools, the old tools I'm going to get rid of. I don't throw tools in the garbage. Never. I have to donate them. Okay. Cause they mean something to me. No matter how cheap and nasty they are, sometimes those are the perfect job or perfect tools for the job if you're in a pinch. And a lot of those tools was that for me too. So I'm hoping to provide that for somebody else in the future. So, all right, you guys, thanks for coming by the shop again. And stay in the word, and we'll talk soon, all right? Love you guys. Stay dangerous, you guys.